Today we're looking at how to approach treatments. What are they, and how do you stand out from the crowd? Hi guys and girls, my name's Scott. I'm a director and cinematographer based out of London, England. Let's talk about treatments. The first time I was asked for a treatment, I was a little confused. I was shooting a music video, stepping in for someone else for this small town band. I didn't exactly know why they needed this treatment, and I wasn't entirely sure what it was. Treatment can take on several forms, but in essence, it's your sales pitch. A treatment presents your vision of the film. It may not be your original idea, but it's how you see it being interpreted through your eyes, the idea. Let's start with the music video scenario. Say that your idea is a one shot of the singer walking down the street, singing to camera. This doesn't tell the reader very much. Yes, they know it's one shot, and yes, they know that the singer will be walking down a street, but is the singer performing in an emotive way? Are they angry? Or are they oblivious to what's going on around them? Are they carefree, moving with purpose? What does the street look like? Is it on a housing estate in suburbia? Or in a busy marketplace somewhere in India? Maybe it's in a desolate, war-torn wasteland. Is there a story unfolding as they walk down this street? Action that narrowly misses the singer, like a car accident or police chase? Perhaps an explosion? Paramedics running, pushing past the singer as they carry on oblivious to the action taking place behind them. What's the singer wearing? Are they in a jean jacket or a clown costume? Is it a green clown costume or a red one? How will it look stylistically? Are you shooting in golden hour? Probably. Or nighttime? There's large neon lights in the background and car lights sweep across the singer's face as they walk down the street. There are a lot of things to consider and communicate. A one-shot video of the singer walking down the street, performing to camera, could be interpreted in so many different ways in someone else's head. In the advertising world, chances are that there's an agency that have written a script. You're going to be one of several or increasingly many different directors that are pitching their interpretation of said script. I directed an ad for a pet food brand in 2017-18. The script read that a voiceover would read and a worker would inspect the crops all the way from growth to harvest. My interpretation of what could have become quite a dull visual was to take this activity and make it more visually interesting by using match frames. Using the match frames, we could show the passing of time, as well as using whip pans and stitching in post to transition between scenes and make it feel like this ever-flowing story. In the treatment, there's often a bit of repeating the idea back to the agency, however in your own words. But then I added my ideas. Timings, info about the way it would look, how sound design would play a part in bringing it to life. And by the time we were showing it to the end client, I even included storyboards. Visuals. Once the idea or the vision is down, use visuals to tell the story. Now, granted, in my pet food example that we started with, it's looking pretty dire, wooden and corporate. In my defense, it was a niche topic to find great or even good stock imagery of. So what I ended up doing is mocking up a load of frames in Photoshop where I couldn't find what I needed. In more recent years, however, I have started to build up my own personal image library using Dropbox. Whenever I see a piece of work that I love, I'll screen grab frames from it and organize accordingly. You can spend a lot of time doing this when you first start to build your library. But if you do it regularly, get into a bit of a routine of just grabbing the odd still here and there as you go, then you'll build up a vast pool of images over time. This library that you're building can also be a great source of inspiration too. Quite often I'll be thinking of a particular image for a treatment and I'll go looking for that image, and on the way to it, I'll find something that sparks inspiration elsewhere. Especially at the beginning when it's small, your image library isn't going to save you every time. There are always going to be specifics that you need to hunt out, but generally in the round, this is the way to go. If I see an advert I like or something sexy pops up on Vimeo, I still continue to build my own library almost weekly. But there is one incredible resource that I will share with you, courtesy of cinematographer Lawrence Shear, ASC, the man behind Joker, Garden State, and The Hangover. Lawrence created shotdeck.com. It boasts an enormous catalogue of grabs from feature films, an incredible search feature, and it still doesn't cost a penny. Larry, you the man. Keep it Goldilocks. Much like our one-shot pitch of a singer walking down a street, singing to camera, you don't want your treatment to be too short. But you also don't want your treatment too long either. It's got to be just right. Goldilocks. Just right. Three bears. At least on the first approach. Cover all the bases. Look, styling, technique, etc. But just don't overindulge. Be realistic. Don't overpromise. If you know the budget's under 5k, then don't be suggesting a shoot in Iceland with a stunt team and heavy visual effects. It's unlikely to happen. That said, I did once pitch on a music video with a 7k budget, and being a bit younger and naive at the time, I massively overpromised what we could deliver. But the label and the commissioner liked it enough that they came back and they said they were going to triple the budget to make it happen. There can be miracles, but not normally. There are a number of programs to make your treatment in. It really doesn't matter. When I started out, I was using Microsoft Word, Google Slides, Photoshop, and now I've come full circle to using Mac's free Keynote. There are actually companies out there that offer the service of designing and even writing your treatments for you based on your idea if you are both rich and lazy, or maybe you're time poor but money rich. I don't know, it's not for me. I don't recommend this approach personally, but it's out there. There are no hard and fast rules to what the agency, studio or commissioner are going to react to, but this is the best advice that I can give. It's also worth checking out a great article over on Film Supply's blog by Diego Contreras. I'll link it in the description below. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to subscribe for more semi-helpful tips and insider industry knowledge. Good luck with those treatments and go win those pitches.